test the class anyway. Those who can test, it's fine. Otherwise, also can join in tomorrow. We can test it again. It's just a, you can use any browser. So I'll update the class link. सदाशिवसमारं त्वां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तुमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः गुरुब्रह्मणविदातिगुरु वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै त्वं आत्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मोक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमोऽयं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलमपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः. So looking at the Nayayikas, Mata and follow-on refutation currently in the Tippana. But it will continue elsewhere also. I mean, continue in the Moola also. So all the Ekavimshati Dukkha Nivarana is Moksha. They are Padartha Krita, Indriya Janya Ityadi. Tasma Dukkha Mityuchyate. They are themselves called as Dukkha in the Nyayamata. Yadyapi Nyayamate Shrotra Manasoho Nityatva Tayor Nashahana Sambhava. How will this dukkha indriya janya shariradikam dukkha janakatva dukkham ityuchyate, that shariradi includes indriya and also manas. We saw this shrotra tvam netra jivha ghrana mana. So mana is also there, manas. So sukha dukkhe, the emotions lead to dukkha. The indriya vishayas also lead to dukkha, and dukkha janakatva dukkha mitti kathyate, and swargadi sukham api nasha bhayat dukkha karanam. This swarga sukha is there. The karmakandis say that you can go to swarga and you'll get nitya sukha. Apekshika nityatvam. Vedantin say it is apekshika nitya, it is not nitya. Compared to this janma sukha and the length of the sukha anubhuta here, compared to that it is said to be nitya. It is arthavada, it is not really nitya. Apekshika nitya. So Nayayika says, yes, swargadi sukham api nashabhaya dukkha karanam. Even when the sukha anubhava is there in swarga as a swargavasi, just like here, when you are having sukha, oh, it is going to end soon. You don't want it to end, but you can't hold on to it. Vishaya sukha, a very close friend, you are having a party and then you are happy with it. You're meeting after a long time, you're discussing whatever, you know, whatever gives you sukha, and then you know that the person is going to leave soon. Dukkha karana. So nasha bhaya dukkha karanam, even while sukha anubhava is there, oh, it's going to go away because you know it is anitya. Similarly, in swarga also it is like that. Yadyapi nyayamate shrotra manasoho nityatvat tayoho nashaha na sambhavati. Shrotra, shrotra is these indriyas. Shrotrendriya, specifically Shrotrendriya here. And manas also is nitya. Anu, nitya. What is Shrotra? Shrotrendriya in Nayayika's Mata, what is it really? The discussion is there in the footnote which continues across pages. So we'll finish the Moola and come back to it. श्रोत्र मनसोर नित्यत्वात् तयोर नाशः न संभवति तथापि येन रूपेण श्रोत्र मनसोर दुःख हेतुत्वं तद्रूपं नश्यति. ऑल्दो दि श्रोत्र एंड मनस आर नित्य इन द नैयायिक मत एंड तज्जन्य दुःख तज्जन्य दुःखत्व तज्जन्यत्व दुःखजन्यत्व दुःखं दुःखजनकत्वात् दुःखं श्रोत्र एंड मनस. हाउ विल श्रोत्र मनस बीइंग नित्य दुखा बिकम अनित्य. हाउ विल दुखा गो अवे. सो येन रूपेण श्रोत्र मनसोर दुख हेतुत्वम. व्हाट इज दैट रीजन? दुख जनकत्वम. सो दुख जनकत्वम विल गो अवे. व्हाई? बिकॉज श्रोत्र एंड मनस ऑल्दो दे आर देयर, देयर इज आत्म संबंध, आत्म संयोग इज देयर. संयोग संबंधत्वात् दुख जनकत्वम. If Atma has no connection with the Shrotra and Manas, then there won't be any Dukkha. So that Dukkha Hetutvam will go away. Although Shrotra and Manas will continue. This is their explanation for Moksha being possible. Although Shrotra and Manas are Nithya, Dukkha still can go away. Dukkha can still go away. पदार्थ ज्ञानोत्पादकत्वात् श्रोत्र मनसी दुःख हेतु भवतः. सो दे जनरेट दी दुःख बाय बीइंग करणा टू पदार्थ ज्ञान. सो पदार्थ ज्ञानोत्पादकत्वात् श्रोत्र मनसी, श्रोत्र एंड मनस आर कॉल्ड एज दुःख हेतु. मोक्ष काले श्रोत्र मनसी पदार्थ ज्ञानम न जनयतः. दे विल नॉट जनरेट पदार्थ ज्ञान. श्रोत्र एंड मनस आर नित्य, दे विल स्टिल बी देयर आफ्टर मोक्ष, बट दे विल नॉट जनरेट पदार्थ ज्ञान. कर्ण गोलकेन अवच्छिन्न आकाश श्रोत्रमित्यभिधीयते. नाउ दिस विल कंटिन्यू इन दि टिप्पण. दि आकाश प्रेजेंट इन दि कर्ण गोलक, इन दि विदिन दि इयर्स, विदिन दि इयर गोलक सॉकेट, दैट आकाश इज कॉल्ड अ श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय इन नैयायिका मत. दट आकाश तच्च कर्णगोलक मोक्ष काले नास्ति. दैट कर्णगोलक इजंट देयर. सिंस द बॉडी डाइज ऑफ दैट कर्णगोलक वोंट बी देयर, सो द आकाश रूप श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय सत्वे अपि, तस्माद् आकाश रूप श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय सत्वे अपि गोलका भावाद् ज्ञानं न भवति. So that sharira, which makes you have sambandha with the indriya also, that won't be possible because sharira isn't there. So akasha is there, akasha rupa shrotrendriya is there, but still karna golaka antargata akasha shrotrendriya rupena na vartate. Therefore sambandha is not possible. Golaka bhavat jnanam na bhavati. अनया रीत्या ज्ञानजनकं यत् श्रोत्रेन्द्रियस्य स्वरूपं तदेव दुःखं तस्यैव नाशः. ऑल्दो दि श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय नाश डज नॉट टेक प्लेस, स्टिल ज्ञानजनकं, अनया रीत्या ज्ञानजनकं यत् श्रोत्रेन्द्रियस्य स्वरूपं, दैट गोज अवे. तदेव दुःखं, दैट इज दुःख कारण, देयरफॉर दुःख, दैट गोज अवे इन मोक्ष, तस्यैव नाशः. Now going back to the Tippana, where this elaborate discussion and refutation is being done of Nayayika Mata in related to Shrotra and Manas. Nyayamate Shrotrasya Akasha Rupatam Abhyubagamya Nityatvam Uchyate. How is Shrotrendra Nitya? Nayayika says Akasha is Nitya. They think Akasha is Nitya. एकः विभुः नित्य एंड आकाश विद इन द कर्णगोलक इज लाइक घटाकाश, इट्स जस्ट अ नेम, बट दैट इज कॉल्ड एज श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय. दैट विल कंटिन्यू टू बी देयर. आकाश विल कंटिन्यू टू बी देयर. देयरफॉर Nityattvam uchyate. We don't accept that Akasha is Nitya. We are looking at Naiyayika Mata. Why is Shrotrendriya Nitya? Because Akasha is Nitya. So Akashasya Nityattvat Shrotrendriyam Nityam. This is their Hetu. Tanna Yujyate. That is not acceptable. Why? Shrutau Netradinam Iva Akasha Shrotrasya Utpatti Kadita. Is Akasha the Karana for Shrotrendriya? Shruti talks about it. Sorry. So it is Shruti Viruddha. Mata Utpatti Matoho Vastunaha. So Utpatti Mataha Vastunaha Nityatvana Sambhavati. You cannot say something is Uppanna but Nitya. That is not going to be possible. Whatever has a beginning will definitely have an end. So this Vastu, which is Shrotrendriya, is created. Being created, it will not be Nitya. Further, Shrotrasya Akasharupatoktirapi Nasambhavati. Now the fundamental. This Shrotrendriya is Akasharupa, that itself is incorrect. Why? Nayayikaha Karnagulakastham Akasham Shrotram Ahuhu. This Akasha, which is present in the Karana Golaka, that much Akasha is called as Shrotrendriya. Only that much, but Akasha is called Shrotrendriya. Not Shariranthargata anything. Tadayuktam. That is untenable. Why? Karana Golakasthi Akashe Satyeva Kadachit Shravana Kriyayaha Mandyam Athva Tasyakriyayaha Abhavahava Sampadyate. The Golaka is there, Akasha is also there. If Akasha, which is Karana Golakastha, then one should always have perfect hearing. Unless the ear is damaged. And therefore, the space within the ear is not there. It is blocked. Then you can say that the Indriya Golaka is not right. Therefore, Indriya is not functioning. But there are many whose ears are all right. They are aging and there is no sense of hearing at all. Keeps on reducing. Why? Akasha is the same. Karana Golaka is the same. How can Akasha being the same, which is Shrotrendriya, not undergoing any change, how is that the hearing is impacted? Na tatha bhavitum arhati tasmat panchikrita bhuta rupaha yaha karana golaka vrityakasha tadanyaha yaha apanchikrita bhuta rupa akasha tasya sattva gunamsha karyam shrotrendriyam utpatti vinasha shali vartate tachya nityam. However, what is really Shrotrendriya? The panchikrita, the grossified Karana Golaka, Karana Golaka Vrityakashaha, which is considered as Shrotrendriya by Nayayika, Tadanyaha. Other than that, there is Apanchikrita Akasha. Apanchikrita Mahabhuta Akasha, the subtle Akasha, which is not grossified yet. Yaha apanchikrita bhuta rupa akasha tasya, what is called as tanmatra in Sankhya. Sankhya is called that as tanmatra. Tasya sattva gunamsha karyam. This we have seen in Vedanta Sara or in Tattva Bodha. Sattva gunamsha karyam Shrotrendriyam. That is Shrotrendriya. And it is utpanna. It is born of the apanchikrita mahabhuta. Sattva gunamsha of that apanchikrita akasha. Therefore, utpatti vinasha shali vartate. It is utpanna and will have vinasha. Therefore, anityam, tachya anityam. So, Shrotrendriya is not the way they think it is. So their definition is incorrect. Their understanding of Shrotrendriya itself is incorrect. Therefore, they have erroneously concluded Nityattvam also, which is also incorrect. Athava tushyatu durjanaha iti nyayena श्रोत्रस्य आकाश रूपत्वाभ्युपगमे अपि तस्य नित्यत्वं न संभवति. सो दुर्योधनः दुष्टः. सो जनरली यू से मे गॉड हेल्प यू. सो तुष्यतु दुर्जना. This is the modern way of the phrase we know. But tushyatu durjana means, oh, let them be happy. Even the durjana, let them be happy. You don't really mean it. You don't care for it. But then it's a nyaya here in Tarka. The nyaya is tushyatu durjana means it's a hypothetical acceptance. Okay, you know, durjana here in dushta tarka. The erroneous tarka which is there, okay, I mean, have it your way. So you start somewhere, have it your way. Are you satisfied? Okay, now let's analyze that. So athva tushyatu durjana iti nyayana shrotrasya akasha rupatva abhyubagami api. That is the hypothesis. You accept, okay, suppose it is so. Then what? Tasya nityatvam na sambhavati. Still, your nityatva conclusion is erroneous. Atmana akasha sambhutaha. It is already there. Akasha is also utpanna, let alone shrotrendriya. So, your shrotrendriya is akasha, right? Shrotrendriya is nitya because akasha is nitya. Akasha itself is not nitya. Iti taitarika vakyam akashasya utpattim bruvatasya. Sorry, bruvatasya. Not have bruvatasya. So it is bruvati shatranta. So taitariya vakyam akashasya utpattim bruvat. Tasya anityatam avedayati. By showing that akasha is utpanna, akasha is siddha, established as anitya. इत्थम आकाशस्य अनित्यत्वे सिद्धे तदेक देशस्य श्रोत्रस्य अनित्यत्वमस्ति इति कैमुतिक न्याय सिद्धम. देन व्हाई शुड एनीवन मेंशन दैट श्रोत्रेन्द्रे इज अनित्य. इट इज आकाश रूप एक देश ऑफ आकाश. ऑब्वियसली इट इज अनित्य. इति श्रोत्रस्य नित्यत्वा संभव ज्ञेयः. सो श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय कैनॉट बी नित्य. एवमेव मनसोपि नित्यता न युज्यते. व्हाट अबाउट मनस विच इज ऑल्सो नित्य इन दी नैयायिका मत. मनस कैन ऑल्सो बी मनस के ऑल्सो हैज उत्पन्न इज उत्पन्न. देयरफॉर इट इज नॉट नित्य. बट व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग विद तार्किका यू कैन गिव मेनी रीजंस. एवमेव मनसोपि नित्यता न युज्यते. मनसः परमाणु रूपत्वम् उपगम्य तस्य नित्यत्ववादिनं किं मनः निरवयवम् अथवा सावयवम् इति पृच्छेत्. They say manas is paramanu rupa. It is of an atomic size. It is like that paramanu from which the entire prapancha is created. That kind of paramanu never goes away. The paramanu is nitya. Similarly, this manas is also nitya. Paramanu rupatvat. Accepting that, they say that manas is nitya. Now that Nayayika should be asked, this manas which is nitya, paramanu rupa, is it niravayavam or savayavam? Is that manas with parts or without parts? Paramanu is without parts in the Nayayika mata. Manasaha niravayavatve tasmin manasi avayava rupa deshabhava manasa atmanasa sanyogena janyasya jnana rupa gunasya utpatya bhava jagadandhya prasanga syat. Now they say that atma has sanyoga sambandha with manas. Then atma has jnana. Now this jnana is twofold. From the Vedantin's perspective, jnana is what? Shuddha chaitanya. And we have seen that even the vritti rupa jnana, which is agantuka, which has utpatti and vinasha, that is also really chetana. Seen with a particular vishaya vritti, but that is also that jnana manifests chetana really. So here jnana, we have to understand, they take it across the board as we have seen earlier. Since jnana takes place in atma, that is the time atma becomes chetana. Otherwise, atma is jada. So atma remains jada as long as jnana isn't there. And this jnana has been shown, this indriya janya and manasa janya, that jnana is what? Dukkha karana. So they think that in moksha avastha, when this jnana isn't there, this dukkha rupa, all this ekavimshati dukkhas are there, they aren't there, atma is jada. Moksha rupa of atma is jada rupa. How does jnana take place? With the sambandha, sanyoga sambandha of atma. So manasa atmana saha sanyogena janyasya jnana, that jnana which is there, in which case manasa niravayavatve sati. If you take the first paksha of manas, has manaha has no parts, two pakshas, niravayam athava savayam. So if you take the first paksha, adye niravayavatve sati, manasa niravayavatve sati, tasmin manasi, in that mind, avayava rupa deshabhavat, there is no part, it is partless. With a partless, you cannot have a sanyoga. So this atma sanyoga, atma manas sanyoga, which you are talking about, there is a sambandha of atma with manas. That becomes jnana karana. That makes atma chetana. Whatever you want to talk about later, but there has to be sanyoga. This sanyoga itself is not going to be possible because manas is niravayava. Atma is anyway niravayava. Two things, two padarthas which are niravayava, or even one padartha which is niravayava, you cannot have sanyoga. They cannot have any sambandha. Let alone sanyoga rupa sambandha, there is no possibility there. Because avayava rupa desha isn't there. To connect, you need some part to connect with. There is no part at all. Manasa atmanasa sanyogena janyasya jnana rupa gunasya, that jnana rupa guna which is there, which takes place in the atma due to manas and atma sanyoga, tasya utpatya bhavat, that is not going to be possible. Jnana utpatti will not take place. What will happen? Jagadandhya prasanga syat, everyone will be jada. There is no sentient entity anymore. There is no person who knows anything, sees nothing, hears nothing. There is no entity which has any jnana. No cognition is going to be possible. But it is possible. Since it is possible, jnanotpatti is there in their own paksha. If jnanotpatti is possible in atma, then manas and atma sanyoga, as you talk about, should be there. If it is there, then manas cannot be niravayava. Okay, then he says savayava manasa. Manas is savayava, it has parts. Savayatve, manasa savayatve sati tasya ghatapatadehe iva anityata nirvivada siddha. If he says that, oh, okay, mind has parts, then we say that we don't need to talk about it at all now. Further, we don't need to have any discussion. Why? Because it is proven as anitya. Why? Because of having parts. Savayatvat anityatvam. Ghatadehe iva. So we have a vyapti here now. Whatever is savayatva will have nasha. So ghata has utpatti, ghatapata adehe iva anityata nirvivada siddha. Without even discussion it is established. Why? Because whatever has parts will have wear and tear, it will go away. There is nothing in this prapancha which has parts and is there forever. Athava, another way to look at it, athva yadi manaha nityam syat tada sushuptau vishesha vijnana janakatva roopa linga bhava gamyah yaha mana manasah sopadane layah sana bhavet. In sushupti the manasa sopadane layah bhavati eva. The mind is resolved in Sushupti Avastha. So mind has resolution in its own Upadana during Sushupti Avastha. That won't be possible if mind, manas is Nitya. So yadi manaha nityam syat, sorry, tada Sushuptau vishesha vijnana janakatva roopa linga bhava gamyaha yaha manasaha sopadane layaha sana bhavet. How do you know that there was laya of manas in Sushupti Avastha? Because there is no vishesha vijnana. So vishesha vijnana janakatva roopa linga, that indicator which tells you there is vishesha vijnana janakatvam, that indicator isn't there anymore. So linga bhava gamyaha, known through the abhava of that indicator, indication that okay, I know I have vishesha jnana, I have ghata jnana pata jnana. In Sushupti also I have some swapna ghata jnana swapna pata jnana. In Sushupti, in swapna avastha, in Sushupti avastha I do not have that. That kind of resolution of the mind won't be possible in Sushupti. If mind, manas is nitya, why? Manas will never resolve, it is nitya. Atavapi hetoho manaha anityatvam eva. Sorry, manaha anityam eva. So manasa anityatvam or manaha anityam eva. So mind is anitya. Why? This hetu is given. Because mind will never resolve. In Sushupti avastha, mind resolves. Athayadi nayayeko vadet. Now he replies saying that atma manaso sanyogaha jnana hetuhu. The sanyoga of atma and manas is jnana hetu as per their darshana. Sacha sanyoga ekasya kriyaya va ubhayo kriyaya va bhavet. Vibhav atmani kriyana kadapi bhavati moksha kale va shushupti kale va bhogan mukhasya adrishtasya abhava manasi api kriyana bhavati. Tasmad atma manaso sanyoga abhavat vishesha vidyanam na bhavati iti. So he counters this. He says, you have assumed that the mind resolves, and that mind resolves in Sushupti, that shows that mind cannot be nitya because it resolves. Now Nayayika says vishesha jnana linga bhava, that you are talking about, that vishesha jnana not being there is because sanyoga of atma and manas is not there. Why is it not there? Because adrushta is over. When does the manas become bhogonmukha? A person wakes up from Sushupti when prarabdha is ripe for fructification. Adrushta is ripe for fructification. You have earned it. You have earned sukha, therefore you wake up to circumstantial sukha. You have earned dukkha, therefore you wake up to circumstantial dukkha. You have not earned anything, you remain in your swarupa in Sushupti without knowing that you are in your swarupa. That is your atma sukha. However, when there is Vishejanya Sukha due for you, which is limited, or Vishejanya Dukha due for you, then you wake up. So this Antakkarana, mind, the manas, it becomes Bhogonmukha when, so Bhogonmukham, manas becomes Bhogonmukha. Or rather here adrushta. So adrushta bhogon mukhasya adrushtasya. That adrushta which makes the antakkarana to focus outward whether in swapna or in jagrat avastha, that is not present in sushupti. Therefore, sanyoga of manah and atma is missing. Manas is nitya, atma is nitya, but the sanyoga is anitya. That sanyoga does not take place in sushupti. It doesn't prove that manas is anitya. It only proves that sanyoga is anitya. Therefore, jnana abhava is there in sushupti because adrushta is missing. Tasmad atma manaso sanyoga abhavat vishesha vijnanam na bhavati. So vishesha vijnana isn't there in sushupti, but it is not because of the mind missing. It is because of sanyoga missing. That sanyoga is missing due to adrushta, prarabdha being missing. Therefore, manas being anitya is not established by your objection. Tadapina sangachate. Siddhanti says that is also not right. Why? Vivupadartina sa sarvavastu naam kriyam vina eva sada sanyoga asti. Now your problem is that you have already defined it. You cannot change your definition. Your darshana says that manas is anu. Atma is vibhu. Now vibhu padarthena sa sarva vastu naam kriyam vina eva sada sanyoga asti. Atma manas sanyoga is always going to be there. Why? Manas is nitya, paramanu. Paramanu parimana. Whereas atma is vibhu. And that vyapaka tattva, vyapaka atma is nitya. Atma manas sanyoga, how will it be anitya? Atma is everywhere, it is always there. Manas is not everywhere, but it is always there. Wherever it is, atma is already there. So if you say in some sushupti avastha, in some nadi, the manas goes. It is very anu, paramanu, rupa. It enters some nadi. There also, atma is there. However, sukshmadi nadi is, atma is there. Why? Because vyapakatvat. Both are nitya. One is anu, another is vyapaka. It doesn't matter. It is always, they are always there together. How will there not be sanyoga? Yatha vyapakena akashena sa kriyarahita parvata vriksha pashanadi naam sada sanyoga asti. There is a typo here as well. So this kriya adrishta making this mind go outward, all that is not necessary. Why? Parvata does not have any kriya. Kriya rahita parvata. Does parvata have a kriya? No. Nayayaka says no. What about vriksha? Does it have kriya? No. Pashana, the stone? No. So they don't have any kriya. Just like your manas, which does not have any kriya backed by adrishta in sushupti avastha. But still, akasha, which is vyapaka, is akasha connected to parvata or not? When is it connected? Always connected, because parvata is in akasha. What about vriksha and pashana? Always in akasha. So sanyoga is always there. Why? Akashasya vyapakatvat. Akashasya vyapakatvat kriyarahitasya parvatasya vrikshasya pashanadinam cha sada sanyoga asti eva. You cannot say that no, sanyoga is missing. So this kriya rahita is the word which is explaining the adrishta not being there. So adrishta is not there, so manas is not focus outward, meaning kriya is not there, right? Then that kriya lacking does not say that sanyoga won't be possible. Sanyoga will be there because one is vyapaka, other is anu, is also not a hetu. Why? Both are nitya. One is vyapaka is sufficient. We say that there cannot be two vyapakas. There is only one vyapaka, one purna. That is atma really. Tatha moksha shushuptyadishu kriyarahitasyapi manasaha vidyamanataya tasya vibhuna atmanasa sanyogasya siddhatvad avashyam vishesha vijnanotpatti syadeva. So in not only in shushupti, you have another problem. He says in shushupti also vishesha vijnana will definitely be there, which isn't there. So there is an issue with your tarka. And going further, since you have countered it, let me show the, dismantle the entire system. Let me dismantle your entire system, how flawed it is. In moksha also, vishesha vijnana will not go away. Ghatapatadi jnana will always be there, which you call as dukkha hetu. That ekavimshati dukkha hetu will continue. Dukkha will continue in moksha also. Your moksha is dukkha rupa. Why? Vishesha vijnanatva. Why is vishesha vijnana there? Because manas is nitya. And Atma is Vyapaka, Sanyoga will be Nitya, Prarabdha will have no play. Why? Because there is this Manas which is always there in Atma, Vyapaka Atma. So none of these explanations of add-on Hetus, they'll work. They'll not work at all. None of these will work. Because of Vibhu Atma having Sanyoga, Moksha Shushupti Adikshu, Natu Tatha Utpadyate, but what is the Siddhanta? There is no Vishesha Jnanotpatti in Shushupti, there is no Vishesha Jnanotpatti accepted in Moksha. Tasma Shushupti Adikale Avashyam Manasa Layaha, so you have to accept mind is undergoing resolution. Punarapi jagrati manasa utpattischa bhavati iti angi karyam. And in jagrata avastha, the mind has utpatti again. So utpatti and laya is there for manas also, therefore anitya. Ittham utpatti nashavad deva manaha tasya nityatva kathanam pralapa eva. It is just babbling to say that mind is nitya. So this is the refutation of the Manas being Nitya in the Nayayika Mata. So going back to Mula. Atmana Saha Manasa Sanyogena Jnanam Utpadyate. This is Nayayika Siddhanta. There is Sanyoga of Manas with Atma. We saw in the Tippana. Such a Sanyoga Nyaya Siddhante Anyatarasya Kriyaya Athva Uvayo Kriyaya Bhavati. Now, how is this Sanyoga taking place, sir? How does Sanyoga take place? When two Padarthas have Kriya or one among them has Kriya. In both cases, Sanyoga is possible. So Parvata is still, you are trekking on the Parvata. There is only one among these two which has Kriya. Parvata has no Kriya. You have Kriya. There is Parvata and Purusha's Sanyoga. You and your friend are shaking hands, both are having Kriya. Thereby, Sanyoga is possible. So, Sanyoga is possible when one or both have Kriya. This is their explanation. Such a Sanyoga, Nyaya Siddhante, Anyatarasya Kriyaya, Athva Ubhayok Kriyaya, Bhavati. Yatha, Vriksha Vihagayoho, Sanyoga, Vihagasya Ekasya Eva Kriyaya, Bhavati. Dvayor, Meshayoho, Sanyogastu, Ubhayok Kriyaya, Bhavati. So, examples are given. Vihaga is a bird or an arrow or something. So Vriksha is still, the arrow or the bird is having Kriya. So Vriksha Vihaga Sanyoga is possible. Then if you look at two sheep, they are having some Sanyoga. You know, you see all, you know, I think I remember seeing this, you know, there's a fight of, they have head-on fights, you know. So we see whatever this. So Sanyoga is possible when both are having Kriya as well. Tatha Vibhavatmani Kriyana Kadapi Bhavati. In Atma there is no Kriya possible. So the second option is out of the question when you are looking at the Sanyoga of Manas and Atma. Okay, Nayayika says, okay, Manas has Kriya. Therefore, in the first option, Vriksha Vihagayoho Vat, Sanyoga Vat, there is sambandha possible, sanyoga sambandha possible between manas and atma. Therefore, jnanotpatti takes place in atma. Moksha kale manasyapi kriyana bhavati. Tasma sanyogavat manaha eva moksha kale nasti. So what do they say? This kriya in the manas makes this sanyoga possible. With Atma, And that kind of kriya isn't there in moksha. Manas is nitya, it is there. Atma is nitya, definitely there. But sanyoga is missing. Why is it missing? Sanyoga vatmanaha moksha kale nasti. How so? Sanyoga is missing. Why is sanyoga missing? That kriya isn't there in moksha kala. Therefore, both lacking kriya, there is no sanyoga possible. Now, this jnanam utpadyate manasa sanyogena, jnanam utpadyate atmani. That is discussed in tippana. Atmana sa manasa sanyogena yadi jnanam bhavati tada shushuktau tadrisha sanyoga bhavat suptothitasya jagarana kale jayamanasya sukha jnanayoho smarana rupasya sukham aham aswapsam nakinchida vedisham ityakarasya jnanasya. That is the smarana rupa jnana. Tasya jnanasya moola bhutanubhava na siddhyet. Siddhanti is questioning that manas and atma sanyoga that you talk about, which is the reason for jnana in atma, jnanutpatti in atma, tada sushuptau tadrusha sanyoga bhava. It was established earlier. There is no sanyoga possible in sushupti. Manas and atma sanyoga is not possible. Suptothitasya jagarana kale jayamanasya sukha jnanayo. Sukha and ajnana. I slept happily and I did not know anything. This is the twofold anubhava of a person who has woken up from sushupti avastha. That is not going to be possible. Iti akarasya jnanasya moolabhuta anubhava na siddhyet. That experience is not going to be possible because there is no such sanyoga possible in sushupti, but there is some sanyoga. Otherwise, you cannot wake up and say that I slept happily. I did not know anything. That has to take place. That recollection is possible and collection is possible. Collection itself is not going to be possible. Moolabhuta anubhava, that collection of the sukha in shushupti avastha and anubhava of what? Ajnana, not knowing anything, that won't be possible. Therefore, moolabhuta anubhavasya abhavat smarana api na shakyate jagarana kale. Kincha atmanasa manasa sanyogena yadi jnanam jayeta tada nyayamate manasa anuparimanatvat tat sanyoga jayamana jnanasya shariraika deshavartitvam eva syat. Now there is other issue. Another issue is that manaha and atma sanyoga is jnana hetu. Then manas is anuparimana. It has an atomic size. Tat sanyoga jayamana jnanasya sharira eka desha vartitvam eva syat. Since the manas has anuparimana, it will be in one part of the sharira. Nayayika says, okay, it is in one part of the sharira. What is the issue? Come to the point. So, krishna sharira vyapitvam na bhavet. It is not there everywhere through the sharira. Throughout the sharira, the mind isn't there. Now the problem is tathasati kantaka vedhadi janya pidayaha krishna sharira vachedena anubhavana syat. If a thorn pricks you, and assume that it pricks you at multiple places, you are walking and it's a thorny path, both your feet are hurt by thorns. Do you have pain in the left leg or the right leg? In both legs? Oh, it is not possible. Why? Where is your mind? Is it, if you argue that it is in my right leg, which is not true, the Nayayika will say the mind exists in some particular place. You will not know a thorn pricking your leg, one leg, let alone two legs. Because mind is located in one part of the sharira. Only if the thorn pricks there where the mind is, you should feel the pain. Why do you feel the pain throughout the body? You have headache also and the thorn has pricked on top of that. In Marathi they say, you know, Dushkalat Terava Maina. So you already have a troubled 12 months COVID situation, and then they extend this by, they say you'll have 13th month in this Samvatsara. You are waiting for the Samvatsara to get over, but there is an add-on month, Adhika Masa. So this is the problem. He says that if your mind is located in a particular place, you will have pain only there. Not you will feel the pain only in that place, not everywhere. But Anubhava is what? You feel pain wherever it is in your body. Siddhanta Paksheiva Manasa Krishna Sharira Vyapitva Abhyupagamena Krishna Sharira Vyapi Pidanubhava Asambhava Rupa Dosha Pariharyapi Shushuptau Sukhajnanayor Yat Samanyajnanam Bhavati Tasya Asambhavaha Apatet. Now if the Nayayaka were to argue, he says, how about your Siddhanta, your Vedanta, what do you say? Manas is Sarva Sharira Vyapi. The mind pervades the entire Sharira, Sukshma Sharira pervades the entire Stula Sharira. We also accept that, let's say, we also accept that. Then what will happen is that this Pida Anubhava, Krishna Sharira Vyapi Pida, the entire body ache, you know, feverish. You have the entire body ache in flu. That kind of Anubhava wouldn't be possible is your objection. That objection will not apply to us anymore because we accept your Siddhanta of mind pervading the entire Sharira. But still you will have an issue, says the Vedantin. Why? What about Shushupti, Sukha and Ajnana Anubhava? That won't be possible if there is Sanyoga necessary because mind has undergone Laya. We want to show Anityatvam. Samanya Jnanam Bhavati. Yet Samanya Jnanam Sarvesham Bhavati. Everyone has this Anubhava of Sukha and Shushupti. And Ajnana Anubhava and Shushupti, Tasya Asambhava Apatet, that will not go away. That flaw will still be there in your Paksha, the Nayayika Paksha. Tasmat Atmana Saha Manasa Sanyogena Jnanam Utpadyata Iti Etad Asangatam Iva. So this Sanyoga being Karana for Jnanutpatti in Atma, that is invalidated. Kintu Atmana Swarupa Bhutam Utpattinash Rahitam Jnanam Nityam Iti Abhyupagama Eva Uchitaha. What is this jnana? This jnana is really chidrupa. This chetana that you are talking about, chetanattam of the atma, which is mulabhuta, it is sarupata jada in nayayikamata, that jnanotpatti due to manasanyoga, the chetanattam of the atma is due to manasanyoga, is erroneous. This jnana in Atma is Nitya. The Chetana is the very Swarupa of Atma. Why so? Satyam jnanam anantam brahma, prajnanam brahma, vijnanam anandam brahma, nahi vijnatur vijnater, viparilopo vidyate, avinashitvat, prajnana ghanaha, chidekarasah yatma, Shuddha Chaitanya Rupa Atma, Sarva Siddhi Vivarjitaha, Nama Rupa Vihinatma, Parasamvit Sukatmakaha Bhava Bhava Kala Vinir Mukta Chid Vidya Dvitiya Brahma Samvittihi Sachidananda Lahari Mahatripura Sundari Saishat Chidavinashatma Swatmetyadi Kritabhida Saishat Chidamalakara Nirvikalpa Niraspada Mahachid Ekaiva Ihasti Mahasatyeti chochyate Sadananda Chinmatram Swaprakasham Ananda Ghanam Anirvachaniyam Jyotihi Sarva Vilakshanam Nirgunam Nirupaplavam Jyotirabhyantaram Jyotirekam Advitiyam Sarva Kalpanatitam Dhruvamaksharam Ekam Sada Chakasti Sachidanandam Ityadi Shrutibhyaha. So many quotations are given. Our focus is not on each of these. Our focus is on what? Jnana, Chit. Satyam Jnanam. Brahma, Atma is Jnanam. That is its Lakshana. It cannot be through Manas Sanyoga. Prajnanam Brahma. Vijnanam. विज्ञातु विज्ञाते विपरिलोपः न विद्यते अलुप्त दृक् कैन नेवर हैव दिस ज्ञान गोइंग अवे. विज्ञातु ब्रह्म दैट रियल आत्मा कैन नेवर हैव ज्ञान लैकिंग चेतना लैकिंग. प्रज्ञान घन इट इज अ कंप्लीट पूर्ण विथ ज्ञान. That kind of chit ekarasaha, one single homogeneous chit as a complete entity, how will that chetana go? If you take away chetana, it will become shunya. Atma is not shunya. That atma, if you call it as a padartha also, that padartha called atma, he has to be chetana. Because Shruti defines it as chetana, that is a very definition. It cannot be borrowing it from anything else through Sanyoga. It is completely ridiculous. Shuddha Chaitanya, Rupa Atma, then Chit, Vidya, Advitiya, Brahma Samvittihi. So this is Chit, explained as Chit. Satchit Ananda Lahari, whatever. Chit, again Chit is there. Satchit Ananda Lahari. So many statements are there. Whatever be the other statements, our focus is Satchit, Chit. Then Saisha Chit. Avinashi Atma, Avinashi Atma. So that chit, talked about a chit through and through the Shrutis, how do you miss it? Even a dullard cannot miss it, and you calling yourself a Nahiyayika, how can you miss this and say that this Chetana is Agantuka? With Manas Sanyoga, you have Chetana Jnana. Saisha Chit, Amalakara Chit, Maha Chit, Sadananda Chinmatram. Chideva Chinmatram, Chit Eva Chinmatram, that is a samasa, that is a tadhita there. So Chit Eva Chinmatra has been talked about a Chinmatra, and you say that Chetana itself is Agantuka. How ridiculous it is. I mean, you should be ashamed to call yourself basing on logic, let alone Shruti. There is no logic there. Sadananda Chinmatram, Saprakasha, that Prakasha is what? It is Chetana, Sarva Vilakshan, all this, and did Jyotihi, Prakasha Rupa, Jnana, Chit, Satchidananda, Chit is sitting there also. So many Shrutis are there, those are the Hetus. You are an Astika, you are not a Nastika, you are Astika. Karya Karana Guna Guni Kriya Akriya Vat Jati Vaktyadina Bheda Kalpana Atyanta Veda Bahya Iti. All these Veda Kalpana that you are analyzing, these Vedas leading to Moksha, all that is Atyanta Veda Bahya. It is completely out of Vedas. Meaning there is not even a single Veda which you can bring in and say that I have based my darshana on this. Because all these Shrutis will be contradicted by your statement. Aparigrahat cha atyanta manapeksha ityado sutra bhashya karadibhi pradarshitam. So this is explained in the sutra. So Brahma Sutras, those who are interested can look into it. We'll not go into all that. So where we here? So jnano, we finished this. Tasmat sanyogavat manayeva moksha kale nasti is what the Nayayika talks about. Therefore, this Vishesha Jnana won't be there, Dukkha won't be there, and Moksha is where Atma is Jada. Tvam Manaso Sanyogena Atmani Jnana Utpadyate Atma Swabhavata Jada Iti Ekadeshine Nayayika Matam. So we'll look at the Jada, Atma is Jada. We'll look at that in the next paksha, next Patha. Currently, we'll just do our Mangalacharana, and then we'll test the Microsoft Teams out. Sukan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namruka Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhya Drukyattu Nirmuna Param Sra Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Hanvattu Nishchitamatihi.